piece of the puzzle here will be Braum for Team Liquid, as that will be there to help sort of protect that Sivir that we know has no built-in flashes and dashes and escape mechanisms.
Yesterday's performances looked bad for Lyra and good for Xsmithie,
and now Team Liquid's jungler is finding his way into the bottom lane very early. Flash is already going to be used on both sides. Damage coming through. First blood going out. Team Liquid matching in, but Hoonie's made his way into the bottom lane, looking to grab one in return. Xsmithie barely getting himself away. Lyra wants to move in with the undertow, and he'll find it. He'll ask him a question, and that's one for one.
Nice.
Good use of the fact that he is playing a fantastic early game champion, yep. And that is going to be a great pickup there for the side of Clutch.
Game
cap and control ward is going to be placed down in the pit to keep him blind, true to the nature of Lee Sin, but it's an easy secure for Clutch Gaming. Not
where Akali gets a lot more complex.
Oh, here we go. Glacial Fissure coming down. Piglet going to be in some trouble. Wild Growth comes out, but it's going to be only wild enough for Team Liquid to grab the kill anyway. Hoonie making his way into the bottom lane, looking for revenge here yet again. Devil is going to be taken very low, almost taken down. Hoonie taken very low now as well. He's going to grab himself the kill onto the enemy AD carry. It's actually Lyra picking it up. I had to question whether or not it was intentional because he was farming the Krug camp at the same time, and so many times I've seen junglers try to use trinkets.
Yeah.
When they had the Herald, but we're going to see the Sivir ultimate used. Team Liquid potentially on the hunt here, but instead just going to be forced away. Clutch Gaming holds control over the Drake Pit area for now. Scuttle Crab speed bonus shrine about to disappear. Infernal Drake has been aggroed. Piglet going to put a couple more bullets into that one, make sure that the fight continues. And it looks like Clutch Gaming is committed to this. Hoonie very high on the heat bar, up to about 80, 90, now dropping back down, trying to keep this managed, ready to drop that equalizer here in the fight. Xsmithie comes over the wall, and Infernal Drake's still going to be taken very low. Who does it go to? It's going over to Team Liquid. Xsmithie again, proving why this man is so good.
Slight farm lead over his opponent in Jensen, but Jensen actually the man with the bounty because of the overall team. Yeah, and they are very good at being able to actually continually increase those advantages. They are looking up to the top side here for Demonte.
Jensen going in. Demonte will go ahead, pop the ultimate here. Jensen, World Ender still building up in the Blood Well. Hoonie's made his way into the top lane now, looking to find some further damage onto both members of Team Liquid. Jensen's World Ender will expire. Xsmithie going in, making a kick back onto Hoonie, who will be taken low. Xsmithie going into the stasis. That's why I called it out earlier. It is a game changer, and Xsmithie will grab himself a kill.
Just beautiful play there from Xsmithie. The kick flash, getting a kill onto Hoonie after he had TP'd in, and they're going to be able to take the top lane turret. But Clutch do fight back, knocking down one of their own in the mid by this wave. But Clutch is the ones to gain mid lane control now. Demonte is pushing this in, so we'll see if TL try to force the issue. They may just look for the fight.
Here we go. Jensen popping the Ghost Blade, looking to go in here. Lyra's going to be taken very low. Hoonie dropping the Equalizer down now into the river. Still low HP on the Clutch Gaming jungler. Hoonie trying to get himself away, will be able to escape the chains. But health bars are hurt on the side of Clutch Gaming. The Equalizer's been expended, but the catch is down onto Impact, and that's a pretty big pick. 5 versus 4 now for the side of Clutch Gaming. Impact has not been able to contribute anything. He's already been killed off, but now Clutch Gaming will be cut to pieces. Jensen will end their world, and that is a double kill.
Damage heavy composition like this.
Ooh, it's scary. Top lane tier 2 being targeted now as well by the side of Team Liquid. Core JJ getting himself in a fight. 1 versus 3. 2 redemption called down as Piglet's going to be in some trouble. Vulcan also taken very low. The Clutch Gaming AD carry's already been popped. Demonte will grab a return kill onto Xsmithie as Lyra will go down. The double kill over to Impact before he falls. It is a 2 for 3, a triple kill for Impact. Demonte and Hoonie looking to clean up Jensen and Corey.
Somewhere between 65 and 80 magic resistance currently, so no matter which one you're hitting, the item is not cost effective at the current point in time. Yes, you can say you're building it for later on when more magic resistance comes in.
He's up against Hoonie, who is known for those carry versus carry matchups, and Impact's doing a great job. Here goes the
end. Oh, Core JJ going in, looking for the Glacial Fissure. It's going to be Lyra having to pop the Ragnarok, but Piglet has been popped himself. Clutch Gaming's already lost their AD carry. Loss will this fight carry? It looks like it might be Hoonie on the bottom side. Impact going into the stasis to just make sure he keeps himself safe, as that is the sign for Team Liquid to go for Baron. They say we're 10,000 gold ahead, your 80 carries in the dirt. We are taking this Baron, and this could be the death knell for Clutch Gaming.
Yeah, and it should be their Baron. They're going to TP in and try to actually contest it. We'll see if they can make anything happen here, though.
It's a rumble with no ult. What's he going to do?
Yeah.
Menacingly look at you while you take it? This is not a play that's going to work out too well for Clutch. They spin the teleport, the number one team in the league. They look like the number one team in the league. People are expecting them to be the number one team in the league. And when you're expected to be number one, what I look for is, okay, now what tells me a team better than good is a clean finish. With this lead, Team Liquid should end the game on this Baron. Let's see if they can find it. Ixmithi will be kept alive. Good teamwork there, making sure that the jungler doesn't get taken down.
Here comes Denzin.
Gonna be eliminated. So much damage coming out from Doublelip. Denzin wants to go into the middle of everyone, able to find a little bit of damage. But Damante stays alive with the stasis. CoreJJ having to go into it himself to keep himself alive. Damante brought down next. Piglet going to evaporate under the might of the boomerangs from Doublelip. Team Liquid, three down on the side of Clutch Gaming. They should do exactly what I just proclaimed and find that win right here.
Yeah, that's going to do it here. Can easily end through top. No chance for Olaf and Lulu to hold on against five TL members looking to stay undefeated.
It looks like 4-0 is not just the dream, it's the reality here for the predicted best team in spring 2019. Team Liquid makes it look easy and take down Clutch Gaming 36 minutes in.
A very clean game here from TL, showcasing some different playstyles, some different champions as well. Impact able to bring out the carry, looking good on the Akali, and Doublelift, I do think they were trying to draft him into a corner there, trying to get out the Ezreal perhaps. The Sivir worked out incredibly well. They kept their turret alive. Good early pressure from Smithy. Good early moves to that bottom side. I think really set up the Sivir for success. And in that late game, it really paid off.
They're trying to draft him into a corner. I'm just thinking it looks like an episode of an old Scooby-Doo thing. They just run under the guy's legs and get out of the corner. It's not that big of a deal. Doublelift getting himself the Sivir, staying away from that sort of trap that Clutch Gaming set. And Clutch just could not find the advantages you said they needed on that Caitlyn and Lulu early on in the game. Yes, we saw some team play from Huni, the level one teleport, putting himself behind in his own lane to make sure bottom lane stayed equal. But this was just a